Have you ever used some of your math skills at work? I am not talking about addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, where most of the time we use calculators or spreadsheets. I am talking about a little more advanced, such as algebra, trigonometry, or even calculus. In IT, if you are a hardcore developer, maybe. Especially when you are working with lots of cryptography, machine learning, graphics, and motions. You also probably have used geometry and physics in your algorithms. How about as a network engineer? Well, sometimes you deal with binary math, but nothing more complex than that. In this video, we're gonna explore how we use more mathematics in Cisco networking. And for those who are new to this channel, welcome. I am your host, name is Dean Armada, and I am your cloud and data center rock star. And on this channel, we talk about tech careers and certifications, trivias and tutorial in cybersecurity, trivias and tutorials in cloud and data center, and my journey as an IT instructor. So feel free to check out the rest of the channel and consider subscribing. We have here our network topology. We have R1 connected to R2 and R2 connected to switch 1. Let's use R1 as our local router. R1 needs to learn the network behind R2, which is 172.16.2.0/24. What do we need to do in order for R1 to learn this network? Well, we will use a routing protocol. Which routing protocol? We will be using EIGRP, Dynamic Routing Protocol. And in dynamic routing protocol, we have what we call metric. Metric is a calculated value in determining the optimal route for sending network traffic. Meaning, metric is simply a value we use to get to that destination network. And how do we compute EIGRP metric? Well, we have two formulas. The first one is if we have values for load and reliability, which is overly complex, at least for me, and we will skip this. And the second formula is more common and the default. No load, no reliability. We just use bandwidth and delay. It looks simple, right? But not as simple as you would expect. Let's make sure we understand both bandwidth and delay value first. Calculating EIGRP metric. So we already have this formula, 256 multiplied to the sum of bandwidth and delay. It's actually not that simple, because under bandwidth, it should be the reference bandwidth with a value of 10 to the 7th power, or 10 million, or 10 mega, over the list bandwidth, plus the total delay. Now, let's talk about more detail. Let's talk about the list bandwidth. This value should be 100 mega because this is the value of both R1 interface E0/0 and R2 interface E0/1. Now, if R2 interface E0/1 is changed to a higher value, let's say 1 gig, the list bandwidth value will remain the same. It will be the same. It will still be 100 mega because 100 megabits is less than 1 gig. Plus delay. The delay should be the total delay of R1 and R2 interfaces, but not in microseconds. It should be 10 to the power of negative 5. And this is why we are dividing it by 10. Here is the math. We're going to start canceling values. So we're going to cancel this, we're going to cancel this, and we're going to cancel this. We need to make sure that our values are simplified. So the result is 256 multiplied to the sum of 100, which is the bandwidth, plus 100, this is the delay of R1, and another 100, which is the delay value of R2. And we all know that if we add all three 100s, the total will be 300. Now we're gonna multiply 256 to 300, and the result is 76,800. Calculating EIGRP metric is that simple. I'm here in our EVE-NGI, and here is our network topology. We have R1 connected to R2, and R2 connected to switch 1. Now, let's verify first the values of both R1 and R2. So from R1, I will do show IP interface brief, and I will also do the same on R2, show IP interface brief. And what I'm gonna do next is I will verify if R1 and R2 is reachable. So from R1, I will ping 10.10.12.2. And as you can see, R1 can reach R2 via interface ETH0/0. Next is, I will also verify the values of both R1 and R2 interfaces. I will do show interface ETH0/0 in R1, and in R2, I will do show interface ETH0/1. And as you can see, the interface has 100 MB or megabits per second. The delay is 1000 microseconds. Under R2 interface ETH0/1, we have 100 megabits per second and delay is 1000 microseconds. Now, let's verify the routing table of R1. I will do show IP route. And as you can see, there is no network learned yet, okay? Not the 172.16.2.0 network behind R2. Why? Because we haven't enabled dynamic routing protocol, EIGRP. And this is what we're about to do. We're going to enable EIGRP using router EIGRP command on both router 1, R1, and R2. All right, so I'm going to use router EIGRP command, okay? And I will use also network 10.10.12.1.0.0.0, okay? And under R2, I will use network 10.10.12.2 wildcard mask 0.0.0.0, okay? And as you can see, it has now formed a new EIGRP adjacency. From R1, it says neighbor 10.10.12.2, which is R2, is now a new adjacency. Now, if I redo show IP route under R1, look, we still don't have this network, 172.16.2.0. And why? Well, it's because we haven't advertised this network from R2. And this is what we're about to do. So still under router EIGRP1 configuration mode, I will now run network 172.6.2.0, and I'm gonna use the wildcard 0.0.0.255 because this network is /24. I'm gonna hit enter now, okay? And we're gonna verify if this new network has been learned by R1. I'm gonna rerun show IP route, and look at that! We have now the network learned, and it's via EIGRP with a code D. And look at the value. This is the metric that we have calculated, exactly the value 76,800. Now, what if the requirement is to get the specific EIGRP metric value? How can we configure our routers so that R1 would get an accurate metric value 179,200 to network 172.16.2.0/24. We already know the formula, but how do we really apply it in this scenario? Let's do this. So the bandwidth is something that we don't normally change, so we will keep it. We need to find the delay value, either R1 or R2. Let's just go with R2. The equation is ready. Let's begin algebra. Let's start first by canceling values. So we're gonna cancel this and we're gonna cancel this. We're gonna make sure that our equation is simplified. The result will be 256 multiplied to the sum of 100 and 100 and x over 10. We're gonna focus first on the right side of our equation. So the next result will be 25,600 plus 25,600 plus 256x over 10. What we're gonna do next is we're gonna simplify further. We already know that 256 and 10 is divisible by 2. So if we simplify this, we're gonna cancel 2. The result will be 128x over 5. Also, we need to get the sum of 25,600 plus 25,600. And here is the result, okay? Next thing we're gonna do is we're going to move the 51,200 value from the right of our equation to the left side. And the result will be, it will be reverse. What do you mean reverse? Well, the 51,200 is positive. If we're gonna move it to the left side, it will become negative. And this will be the result. As you can see, we got 179,200 minus 51,200. The next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna move the value of 5 from the right side of our equation to the left side. By doing this, we will reverse the 5 as a divisor to 5 as a multiplier on the left side of our equation. Okay, so the result will be this. So it's now 5 multiplied by the result of 179,200 minus 51,200, which is 128,000. And on the right side, we still have the 128x. Now we just need the x value. So we're gonna move the 128 value from the right side of our equation to the left side. 128 is currently a multiplier. It's on the right side. If we move it on the left side, it will become a divisor. So it would look something like this. We have now 640,000 over 128. And if we get the result, x value is equivalent to 5,000. I am back in our EVE-NG, and we're going to apply the delay value based on the result of our computation. But first, let's verify our routing table from R1. If I rerun show IP route, as you can see, the metric hasn't changed. It's still 76,800. Now we'll go to R2. And in R2, let's do show interface E01. The delay value is still 1000 microseconds. And we're going to change this. We'll go to interface E01 and we're gonna use a command called delay. Now, we're not going to use 5000 exactly. Why? Because if I hit question mark, it says here, the value is the throughput delay in tens of microseconds. So meaning this is not microseconds, but rather this is the value, the power of negative 5. This should be 5,000 over 10, which is equivalent to 500. So this should be the correct value in our configuration. Okay, I'm gonna hit enter and let's verify again the show interface 01. Look at that, the delay value is now changed to 5,000 microseconds, although we use delay 500 in our command, okay? Now, I'm gonna verify if our metric has changed, okay? Okay, by rerunning this command, show IP route. This is the moment of truth. Okay, and I'm gonna hit enter. But wait, before I hit enter, I'm gonna close my eyes because I love suspense. I'm gonna close my eyes and I'm gonna hit enter. And there you go. Look at the result. It's exactly what we expected. We are successful. Woo! And this just proves that our algebraic computation of finding the delay value to set EIGRP metric to 179,200 is working properly.